Hi, in this video, we'll be creating a persistent volume backed up by a NFS server and see how we can use that inside a pod. So first, we'll see the PV. Now, we'll create this PV, and it is a PV with the manual storage class, capacity defined, read-write many access mode, and this particular section is where we define NFS. So in NFS, we define what is the server and what is the path that we have shared. So let's create the PV, kubectl create hyphen f and PV. So the PV is created. Now let's look at the PVC. So PVC is again very straightforward. So storage class name, access mode, and the resources where we define the request section. So kubectl create hyphen f PVC. So we have get PV and PVC. So we have both PV and PVC created, and it's bounded because it's the manual one that we have created. So it's already in bound mode and won't wait for the pod to come up first in order to get bounded. And now let's see how we can use that inside a pod. So pod. So in the pod spec, we have defined a volume section, and in volume section, we have used persistent volume claim that we just created, PVC NFS, and the container section, we have used image alpine, and in the volume mount section, we have mounted that inside the container under slash MNT directory. And it, this particular pod will just, print out the, cat out the memory info and store that as a memory.txt file. So in the NFS server, it should also be creating this particular file. So let's go ahead and create this kubectl create hyphen f pod. The pod is created and it's running. So kubectl, we can actually do an exec, kubectl exec hyphen it pod using NFS. And let's go to cd slash mnt. We should be seeing a memory dot txt file. And you can see there is data in it as well. Now I have an NFS server already open, and previously you can see it didn't have any data. So let's do ls again. Now it should be having the memory.txt, and it is also getting updated. So this is how the NFS server, which is outside of the cluster, can be used as a persistent volume inside a pod. This is a scenario which can be used actually in production as well, where you have a volume which is outside of the cluster, so that even if the cluster goes down, your data remains safe and can be recoverable. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.